The biggest outstanding issue, I think the process in itself is well organized. It is approved by IMO. It will be implemented, and I think in general ship owners approve of that. But the big challenge here is that the political work to get the EEDI in place has been tremendous, but the technical work that remains in order to become an index which can be trusted by the industry, not only industry but actually the society, there's a lot of technical work that needs to be done yet. And even though we will get it into place for the 1st of January 2013, we are still on a steep learning curve about how we can ensure this level playing EDI. It will not be a level playing field the 1st of January 2013, but we need to ensure that it will become level playing field in the future. And therefore, I think we need to somehow get this feedback loop into place so that the learnings that we get in the first years, that they can be implemented at a later point in time. The Green Ship Technology Conference, it's an interesting conference. This is my third conference. The biggest thing about the conference is, in fact, that there's a lot of people here from the industry. You meet a lot of people with a lot of opinions. You can exchange point of views and learn about new technologies and so on. That is the most important thing, I think. But of course, there are also interesting presentations here, which we have several people from Maersk attending the conference, and it's definitely interesting. The first thing I can say is that in Maersk we have for many years have fuel efficiency as a part of the whole business, you could say. We have always been paying a lot of the fuel ourselves, and therefore we have been doing performance monitoring, actually not the last couple of years, but for more than 40 years. So you could say that in the company it has been a tradition for many years to actually work with fuel efficiency. So it's not something which is new in Maersk, it has always been on the agenda. But on top of that, of course, as the situation is now with all these new regulations coming in, and there's an increase in fuel prices, and of course the requirement for a greener business in Maersk, we think that our ticket to survive in the future, that is to do sustainable shipping. There's a lot of efforts going on, and those efforts, they are about designing new vessels which are more fuel efficient than previously. It's about looking at the existing fleet, how can we improve the existing fleet with introducing new technologies. We call it Eco-Retrofit, this project. It scans all the vessels and to see what we can do to improve. And then, of course, there's a whole operational part. I think it's fair to say that Maersk has been one of the companies breaking the ice for doing slow steaming. That is an operational thing, and for sure that will. I think that has made a trend in the industry that everybody can see that it is saving CO2, it's saving fuel, but it's definitely the way to go forward to become green operators. So, yeah, designing new ships for the right operation, looking at technologies for existing ships, and then working with the operation to improve the operation to be more efficient from that perspective as well.